the pinky held up this week?
It's been okay. I took a day off early in the week to try to give it some rest. But you know, it is what it is. It's going to be sore. So I just have to make sure I can tolerate the pain and go from there.
Is that any question for Darian Durant, tolerating pain?
You know, I think I have a high pain tolerance. I played through a lot of injuries, and this will be no different.
What do you lose, if anything, with a pinky injury? Velocity on the ball?
I don't think you necessarily lose velocity. It's just, it's harder to grip it. You know, it's harder to, you know, get rid of the ball quickly if blitzes are coming and different things like that. I think it has, you know, it has a lot to do with the grip, not necessarily the velocity. Once you get a hold to it and you're able to sling it, then, you know, it'll go where you want it to. But it's the initial making sure you have a good grip on it.
Matter, DeMarco, Buck, who starts?
You know, not really, because, you know, they're going to probably bring a little bit. DeMarco, I'm sure, will be a little bit more athletic running, and Buck will have a little bit more experience. But, you know, BC's a great team. They're going to have whoever's behind the center prepared. Chaplain's been there forever, and I know it's just a quarterback factory over there. You know, after Dickinson, you have Lule. After Lule, you have Pierce and DeMarco and Riley. So it's whoever's going to be back there is going to do a good job, and we got to just try to neutralize them.
How important is this stretch run, the next 7-6 against?
Every game's important. You know, we're getting down the stretch run, and, you know, we've lost a couple in a row, and, you know, people are starting to panic, but we're not. You know, we're still second in the West, and we're hopefully going to keep moving up the standings and keep winning football games.
Ryan Phillips has had a pretty good career against Darian Durant. Have you come here and told him some of what Ryan has told you, or you learned against going against Ryan?
No, I mean, the thing is, you know, playing with those guys for so long, you know what makes them tick, you know what their strengths are, and you know what their weaknesses are. And, you know, I try to give little pointers on you know, what those are for each guy. And but the thing is, we got to run our offense and run our plays and you know, get the matchups that we feel that can help us win games. And I think we have a good game plan going into this week.
You have many friends. I think Ryan Phillips is one of your good friends on that team.
You know, I have so many guys, you know, Dante Marsh and Corey Banks. They're, you know, those guys, their kids stay at my house when they come into town. And, you know, Dante's son stayed with me for 2 weeks at one time. And, you know, we babysit Corey's daughter. So it's one of those things, man. You know, those guys are like brothers to me. And, you know, I love them to death. But, you know, like I said, when it's game time, you know, all that stuff's out the window. We just got to go play football.
Justin Goltz, not a lot of tape on him when he played Justin Goltz. Same with Zach Caleros, now possibly Thomas DeMarco. How do you game plan around quarterbacks you may not have a lot of film on?
Well, when we game plan, you know, we have a depth chart, you know, so whatever is the next guy that we're hearing that we're supposed to be up, we game plan, you know, the guy before him is him as well. So we're just going in the game as a defensive lineman, just mainly by the offensive lineman, you know. So once we know what guy's playing, you know, you may have a guy that's a scrambler, you may have a guy more of a pocket specialist, and we can kind of game plan for that.
Thomas DeMarco can run around a lot. How much will contain be a factor on Sunday?
Well, I mean, unfortunately, you know, the quarterbacks we played the last few weeks have been able to get out of pocket. So it's not really nothing new for us. We're just going to continue to do what we do and hopefully be successful at it.
This defense has been keeping the offense in it, but the offense has struggled. How much is it imperative that this team stays together and there's no frustration on one side of the ball or the other?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's how it goes in any football team. Yeah. I mean, you have three phases, defense, offense, and special teams. 1 week, you know, it'd be perfect to have all three phases on the same page, and we've been fortunate enough to have that. But as the season goes along, you may have one phase and not playing as well as the next. So when you have chances like that, you just have to just bow up and not bend. There's been a lot of weeks that the offense kind of bails us out. So they're not doing too well. We just have to be on our P's and Q's and do what we know we can do.